Hey guys, welcome back to the Anthro Block with Insetic and Blake Tester. This is ATV Racers for the PlayStation 1.
Yes, a 2003 PlayStation 1 game.
Yeah.
Featuring adorable anthropomorphic characters and an option screen. Let's find out what's on the option screen.
Yeah.
Up.
Up.
It's gotta go up.
Oh, way too up.
Let's do it.
Way too, no.
150 lap, 150, we'll do it off camera.
Off camera.
You and me.
All right.
1v1 me.
Just looking to see if they do, like, it's 2003. Would they have, like, widescreen options, you know?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Actually, wait a second. I kind of assumed there'd be multiplayer. I hoped there'd be multiplayer.
There's no multiplayer. That really pisses me off. What the fuck is this?
I don't know. Okay, here, I'll just do...
really sad. You know what? I'm really sad because...
You want to be really happy? Look at these guys.
Like Charizard.
Look at these guys.
Cadmus? More like Charizard.
Wait, whoa. How do you have the Charizard guy, but someone else is named Chaz?
The other guy's name is Cadmus. What are their other names?
Argyle.
That's a cool name.
Rocco.
Okay.
Flossie.
I don't know how I feel about
Pauly.
Oh, that's pretty tight.
Why does Rocco have really yellow teeth?
I don't know. Maybe he's got a grill.
Yeah, alright.
Yeah. You know, this really pisses me off, though. Like, I thought there would be multiplayer, because it says, in ATV Racers, on the back, it says, in ATV Racers, there are no rules. Anything goes. I would think multiplayer would be one of the things that goes.
Maybe.
But apparently there's a rule that says... Only one player
Maybe
at a time.
Maybe we could invent our own multiplayer. Like, I'll just throw the controller at you halfway through the first lap.
Okay. I was thinking maybe at the end of laps, but...
No, I mean...
So you're telling me you can turn it on so that you have 50 laps shit. By yourself?
Yeah. Or if I really want...
Look at how cute he is!
Oh, my God.
Oh, you can't go outside those
You
lines.
Can't turn... Wait, didn't you say DualShock was enabled?
I believe so.
Because it's not. Oh, wait.
Is it working now?
Yes, it's just this is my turn radius.
You turn on a football field?
So what are the controls?
Okay, steer left and right with the directional buttons or the thumbstick. X to accelerate, square to brake, triangle to change camera view. I wonder if there's a first person. Wow, that's barely different. L2 is for rear view, R2 is to fire your weapons, and starts to pause.
Are you seeing this turning?
I'm hearing about it from you.
Ah, turn!
Fire. Fucked up.
Oh, sick tricks. Yeah.
Holy shit.
That's what I've been looking for this whole time.
See, this isn't. This is definitely still an extreme sports game.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, granted, somehow we've ventured off in just during the Anthro Block into kart racers, but this is still an extreme game.
I mean, I think it started as kart racers and is going to end as kart racers.
Well, I mean.
Well, you're
right. As part of our extreme sports series.
All right, you got this.
Oh, shit. No rules.
Pass and play.
Gotta go fast.
Yeah.
So there's rockets and there's mines. And that's it. And, oh, when you turn on analog, it disables the buttons.
Does it?
Yeah.
Like the D-pad?
Like the D-pad. It doesn't
work. You can turn it off.
No, that's okay. I prefer the thumbstick. I was just thinking,
Oh, fire that shit. What is that?
The rockets. R2, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
Wrecked.
Ah, damn it. What? So maybe there's like a boost?
I guess.
So there's like a homing rocket. God, these little motherfuckers are so cute.
Yeah. Man, this is like if Digimon had a kart racer.
Digimon sucks.
Man, that
We're playing as Charizard and you're talking about Digimon over here?
I don't know, I'm just saying, you know?
2003. They couldn't...
Are we sure that... No, it said 2003 in the loading screen.
Oh, fuck you, Mud Duck.
Mud Duck.
I know you're a subsidiary... Nice.
Nice. Idiot.
Yeah, fucking idiot.
You know what else?
Oh, God, listen to this music.
You know what else you could play in 2003? Like, anything else?
What?
No, like, anything else.
Oh,
I mean, you could play Mario Kart Double Dash in 2003.
Shit, Double Dash, yeah.
Would you rather play Double Dash or ATV Racers?
ATV Racers. You don't get the sense of speed with Double Dash.
You're right. But you
What the fuck was that?
You don't get the sense of turning with ATV Racers.
What? I'm in fourth place.
Yeah.
Fuck you.
Man, that guy does 6-7-20s.
Yeah, he does.
Oh,
third place.
Right at the end. Oh, man, I did
God, look at his face.
We did it.
Why does everybody drive a pink ATV? I wonder how much longer we can just sit here.
Sit here.
Jesus. I was really hoping this would be multiplayer.
I was really hoping there'd be more than
rules.
This.
I was hoping there'd be more rules too. So let's see. When the back says,
I guess we can just keep
choose one of 10 characters to drive your ATV. Use guided rockets and mines to foil your opponents. Pilot your ATV over a variety of dangerous courses. In ATV racers, there are no rules except that
you can't go out of the white lines.
Except like, you can't go out of the white lines.
They render stuff outside of those lines. They show paths that you should be able to take.
Hold on, go back up to the top left.
Hogan?
That's fucking Hulk Hogan, dude.
Dude, he's wearing a bandana or something.
That's Hulk Hogan!
Shit, I gotta be Hulk Hogan.
Maybe not now. With all the politics going on.
Yeah,
you don't want to
I guess I'll be,
let's be Charizard.
Wait.
Has Charizard said any racist things?
No. Okay. Charizard's just burned people up.
Yeah, nobody cares about that.
So, wait. What place did you get? Did you win?
I think third.
Oh. Is third not good enough to unlock anything new?
Maybe you gotta be in a tournament.
You probably do. What am I thinking?
I really want to do a 50-lap one.
Oh, you could do that by yourself after this.
Here, let's see how short this lap is.
All right. Well, the lap is short, but the turning is long.
No, I mean like if the lap is short, we can do a 50-lap one and just cut around. I really want to.
Okay, but do you really want to play it, or do you want me to be the one?
I'll play it. I can play it.
Okay.
Turning!
Okay.
Maybe you need to start turning, like, super duper early. Like... What? He just did a sick trick all by himself! Didn't even hit anything!
It's like...
What the hell is that? What?
Oh, probably like a shield or something.
What? Okay, I'm going back into the book.
Back into the book? It's filling you full of surprises?
This is confusing the shit out of me. Let's see.
Oh, I just ran that guy right into.
What about the weapons? There's a big fucking insert in the middle. Oh, so there are stats to the characters.
Oh.
But they don't tell you that.
Is one of them turning?
Speed, mass, control.
Mass?
Yeah.
Oh, is one of them getting boned?
Yeah, I think so.
Alright, well, Charizard's bone meter is off the charts right now.
Wow!
What?
Charizard's got twos and everything.
Nice. I guess it's
out of five.
Oh. Bad.
Pauly has a 4, a 5, and a 1.
Wait. So
the distribution's not even fair.
2-2-2 versus 4-5.
Chloe has a 4-3-3.
I have to see this.
Like, Rocco and Cadmus both have twos in everything. But Argyle, who's one of the characters you unlocked right at the beginning, it has a 3, a 2, and a 4. That's so unfair.
So what about the other characters we have at the beginning?
Okay,
like,
so Hogan,
two of them are locked.
Hogan's
so
3, 2, 4.
Okay. Wait, still bad. Was Cadmus and the other guys supposed to have 3s and everything, and they just messed that up? Like,
that
would make twos. That would make sense. But this doesn't make sense.
Ahab has...
Wait, how am I in third? There was nobody in front of me. I've been racing alone with nobody in front of me.
They're about to lap you. That's what's happening.
I think I need to play with, like, the best character, so...
Speed, mass, and control. I don't know which is the most important thing here, because Cadmus fucking blows.
Oh, that's why I threw
Charizard.
A grenade for you.
Did you say threw a grenade for you?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Charizard really blows. I mean, like, damn. Like, Charizard just sucks.
If he has twos and everything, I want to play one.
Okay, so, let's see. Okay, so... Oh, I came here to talk about, to look up the weapons, but...
But tell me about the characters, please.
Okay, Hogan, 3-2-4. That's the speed mass control.
Yeah.
Ahab, 4-5-1. A 5 in mass. And and a 1 in control. That sounds awful. Chaz has a 1 in speed, a 1 in mass, and a 5 in control.
Okay.
Are there cheat codes?
Yeah, hold on a sec.
Go ahead and put those in.
Options. Do I just do it on this screen?
I guess. That sounds like it.
Yep. Yep, there we go. Released December 2003.
Wow.
We're not bullshitting you, folks.
Oh, there's a character called Picasso.
Yeah.
And in the book it says, Picasso is probably the greatest racer of all the characters.
Yeah, and what's
5-4-3. A 5 in speed, a 4 in mass, and a 3 in control.
Is there anyone with, like, really good speed and control but not mass?
Let's see. Argyle has a 3 and a 4 for speed and control, with a 2 in mass. Yeah.
Not really.
Yeah, Hogan and Argyle.
Well, still, I'll try Picasso. And now that I have all the tracks.
Is this really all the tracks? So 9 tracks. With 3.
God, I'm feeling like I'm playing Snowcross 2 again.
You want me to play?
Oh, you want to do your 50 lap thing?
Happily.
Alright. And you can do Picasso. Hello?
I'll play as Picasso, yeah. In game options. You want to set the difficulty on easy? Yeah, fuck it. I don't want to do 50 laps and lose.
But you do want to do 50 laps.
I do want to do 50 laps. Okay.
Well, if you really want to do a 50 lap thing, then I guess lock the options in.
You know what?
What?
I should probably turn this off. Should I do a tournament?
No. You want to try one of the characters with insane turning?
Yeah.
Okay, do Chaz. That middle option, I think, up the top, yeah. He's slow, he has no mass, but he can turn.
I'm gonna do it Atlantis 3. That's my favorite course from this game.
Yeah. He can turn on a dime.
But I can't drive for shit.
There we go. 1 out of 50.
Oh, God.
I don't want to know how long this is going to take you. Then again, I can kind of probably...
Look at them zipping away from me.
I can probably estimate it out. So do you feel like your turning is a lot better?
Yes.
Actually?
I was hoping to hit more than one person there, but...
Can it even hit more than one person?
Maybe. I don't know. God, this music is great.
This MIDI music?
Yeah. This is about as MIDI as it could possibly be.
Do you know where we were in 2003?
Where I was?
Where gaming was.
Gaming was further than this.
We were in the middle of PS2, Xbox, GameCube. We were playing such games as Halo.
Halo 2 is getting really hyped.
Halo 2 is going to come out next year. And instead... Some kid out there, some poor schmuck, was playing.
Some stupid ass parent.
Gave their kid this. ATV racers.
Yeah. Did we get this used? Wow, that
fucks
you up.
Yeah, we did. For $5.
So some asshole bought this for their child.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing their child never forgave them.
Their child still despises them.
You know, that doesn't say second down there in the bottom, it says two, no.
No reason.
No.
But anyway, what do you think happened to that child? Do you think that child...
Dead.
Wow, that got dead. Dark.
Yeah.
See, I was thinking...
He played 50 laps.
He played ATV racers all day just to wish the pain would go away.
So I don't think I'm ever going to catch up to this guy, even with boosts.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Oh. You have to take those turns inside.
Are the characters looking at each other?
Yeah.
They put time and effort into that.
but they didn't put time and effort into anything else.
They didn't put time and effort into designing courses.
Damn, you're weaving through his stuff.
Yeah.
Wait, you're on Atlantis 3?
Yeah.
This looks just like Atlantis 1.
Well, yeah, I mean, it was made out of the same materials.
And like, underground. The underground one had, like, elevation changes. This is just a flat plane.
Yep. Dangerous courses. See, what's dangerous is, on lap 45, the cracks in the wall above us covering the water,
yeah,
those disappear.
Oh.
Yeah.
See, I thought it was dangerous because you tune out from not
or
giving a shit, and you just drive right into a wall and your guy would die.
Yeah. Flossie would be no more.
Yeah, you would actually lose the option to pick him on the character screen.
Right. And then it would, then Sonic the Hedgehog would look you right in the face and say, I am God.
You only get 8 chances to beat tournament mode. You know?
I was pretty sure this game was haunted, but I put it in my cartridge, or I put it in my PS2 anyways.
Don't buy that game, said the attendant. It's not worth it.
He said with a big smile.
Yeah. Little did I know this game would haunt me for the rest of my days.
Yeah. I woke up and Flossie was looking me in the eyes.
Yeah. I woke up and I looked in the mirror and I was Flossie.
Oh my god. Picasso was cutting his own head off.
Come play with us, said Chaz. Come play with us forever.
Hey, I'm Charizard.
Yeah. I saw there was a new option.
No, I went outside and I looked to my right, and right next to, like, next door, there was Cadmus approaching, but luckily I was easily able to outrun him. I took a corner too quickly and he just wasn't able to keep up.
I saw there was another option. I could increase the laps past 50 up to 1,000. No. It let me go up to infinity laps. I picked it just because I, you know.
Oh, fuck you. Not you.
I picked it. I figured, haha, no one would actually put this in the game. Little did I know, I would never escape.
Jesus. I feel like we should maybe make a creepypasta.
You'd make a creepypasta about ATV racers and people would say, nothing like
that
game doesn't exist.
Yeah.
And we go,
have you ever heard of a game called ATV Racers by Mud Duck?
I didn't think so. Well, let me tell you, if you ever see the game, do not buy it, or it will destroy you.
I tried to find information on the company Mud Duck, and none existed.
Yeah. I called the number they gave me.
Oh!
Nice. I called the number they gave you in the booklet, and when the telephone picked up, all I heard was screaming.
I looked in the booklet for a number to call for customer support, and it said customer support 666.
6666.
No, just,
oh,
just the 3 digits.
Yeah.
I thought, that's weird. That's not a normal phone number.
That's...
But I called it anyways.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this guy. Wow.
Oh, wrecked.
So,
I
don't know where the other people
are. Yeah, I know that you're not lapping them.
I'm not lapping them. They must be, like, right behind me.
Yeah.
Can you... What? It was triangle to change views.
Yeah, but
no,
it was...
Look behind you button.
No, I thought there was.
If there is, I'd like to see.
There was, clicking on all the... Yeah, L2.
Oh, my God! It looks behind you in first person?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, at least they're not right behind you at the moment.
I don't have a clue where I'm going when you do that.
But they might be right behind you after you, you know, wreck your face.
You might as well show, like, my shoulder.
Oh, wait. I think you're about to lap someone.
Oh, shit.
Who's the guy in first?
I don't know.
He's yellow.
Yeah, maybe he's,
probably is, like, one of those...
probably Hogan. He's got pretty rounded stats.
You think the AI is burdened by inability to turn? Or they know exactly when to start turning.
That's true, these are probably...
He's probably, like, Picasso. Preset. That's the... No, Picasso was brown. He was probably, like, Chloe.
I don't know where he is. He's
Chloe,
really...
I think. Chloe's an aggressive lion cub.
Oh, that might be it.
Wait.
If he had the bumpy for that fucking thing.
What do his profiles say?
I don't think that's Chloe.
You think that's the guy in first place?
Yeah, I think so. Nope.
That's the guy you're laughing.
That's the guy in last place.
Yeah, that's the guy in first place right there.
Yeah, that looks maybe like a lion cub.
All right, let me go over these characters.
Okay.
Hogan is a dinosaur who loves racing. He is a dedicated biker, and his bandana and leather jacket are his most treasured possessions.
Brother?
Hogan tends to get very cross if he doesn't win. Only the best will do. Luckily, he is a skilled driver and easily capable of winning if he tries hard.
He can also body slam you.
Yeah, he could also go, you know, send you quarter to quarter in no time.
Yeah.
He could leave you on the ropes.
Oh, fuck you.
Ahab is a friendly bear who likes his honey and only races for the fun of being with his friends. Aww. He doesn't take racing that seriously, but his weight and clumsy manner mean that other racers must always stay alert and keep their distance.
Jeez.
So he's basically going off for a Sunday drive.
Granted, the kid's dropping grenades all over the racetrack, so...
Yeah, he's a friendly racer. He's fun and friendly, but he still likes to use what, you know, is available to him.
Seriously, they've got all these cutesy logos for most of this stuff. And then for, like...
The grenade.
For the grenade, it's just looks a like grenade. A grenade.
Yeah. Like, yeah, that just looks weird, but... Chaz is an excitable squirrel who craves excitement.
Huh. Oh, imagine that.
Even though he appears to be a nervous wreck. Oh my god, he's got like PTSD or something.
I mean, he's dropping grenades all over the battlefield.
I remember.
Some of my best friends were grenades.
Some of my best friends died to grenades.
Yeah.
On the racetrack. Alright, anyway, he has to take risks and zip agilely between other racers as his vehicle is a bit slow. He is always extra alert, as the heavy characters often knock him flying.
Wow.
Cadmus.
I think I'm about to laugh someone else.
Cadmus is a friendly little dragon.
He isn't capable of driving.
He has promised never to breathe fire during a race.
Or turn. He's promised never to turn.
I feel like the world of ATV racers is holding some dark secrets.
So now I mean like, I don't know, I guess...
Double first?
Triple first. Because I've lapped two people.
Like, you know, like, the last dragon to race in the ATV racer circuit burned everyone to death.
Oh,
and
God.
Scored, you know what?
I thought you were saying, like, Cadmus was the last dragon, like, alive, and he's dedicated his life to, instead of, like, reconstituting his
people. I feel
people,
like...
Instead, he's just ATV racing and losing.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know... Tell us what you think of... Yeah, well, I'm still reading characters.
Yeah, yeah.
He loves driving, but his carefree attitude makes him less competitive than others. But he'd still breathe fire on them if they hadn't made him promise not to.
Whoa, wow, that's dark.
No, that's not in there.
Oh, thank God.
That's something I added.
I was gonna say.
He's a bit of an all-rounder, and...
No, he's not!
And usually finishes a race in the middle of the pack.
He usually finishes dead last!
He's a good friend of Rocco's.
Yeah, he couldn't outrun the fucking meteor that kills people. Dinosaur.
Polly is an unlucky beaver who is afraid of water. He took up racing as his phobia meant that he couldn't build dams.
Dude, this is really dark.
I get if you're...
That's so sad. He can't even build his own home?
If you're unable to build dams, you have to enter the rough and tough...
He's afraid of water, so he went to Atlantis.
Yeah.
Maybe he has, like, a track penalty.
You're worthless as a beaver, Polly. You're worthless as a beaver.
Like, imagine, he's fine in these tunnels, right? But then the second he gets out there, he just starts screaming.
Oh my god!
Make it go away! And you're like, Jesus. I'm just trying to play my fucking game.
I didn't want to hear that today. Alright, anyway. He also hates getting cold and wraps up warm for each race. Polly is quite an aggressive driver and can certainly throw his weight about.
Yep.
Flossie is a skinny lamb who loves the thrill of racing.
Yeah, and the thrill of the kill.
Her slow vehicle doesn't put her off, as her agility means she still gets around the track about as fast as everyone else does.
Mm.
She has to keep clipping her wool between races so that she can see where she is going.
I'm about to lap another person.
I think you're about to lap the guy who wasn't... No. Well, I can't tell. There's too few pixels. Anyway, Rocco is... Well, a raccoon with a serious addiction to speed.
Oh, God. That's so dark.
He has twos across the board as well, so...
Dude, he's got an addiction to a drug. This is fucked up.
Rocco uses his winnings every race to buy more drugs.
To score more...
Score more speed.
Jesus Christ.
I like how earlier when I said that...
Cadmus is addicted to X. What the fuck?
Earlier when
he's a happy little dragon.
Earlier when I said that thing as a joke, it just makes me laugh now that it was just close enough to what could actually be in here.
What?
What did I say? That, like, you thought I was... You didn't know I was kidding. I don't remember now.
Oh, yeah, the,
Oh, yeah, he would breathe fire on his friends if they didn't
make... If he could.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he made a promise not to breathe fire during the race. That's basically in, you know, more subdued wording, kind of the same thing.
Well, it's either that he would if he could, or that nobody trusts him.
He would if he could, or he can't, so he shan't. Alright, so, Whoa. I didn't finish the sentence, holy shit. A raccoon with a serious addiction to speed, Rocco is so in love with racing that he often forgets to brake and hits other people, even though he is well able to race with the best of them.
So you're telling me that when he's sober, he's capable, but then he frequently gets high before races.
And causes actual wrecks. Wrecks if not casualties. You know, if the ATV racers...
I'm going to try to do a lap backwards.
You're never going to be able to.
No, I'm not going to be able to.
He is usually quiet and likes to read, but put him in the driving seat and he goes wild. Argyle is an aardvark. Period. He loves to gulp down lots of ants or termites between races.
Weird.
Ants have been known to trail from his vehicle during races, often getting in the eyes and ears of other racers.
First of all, so weird. Second of all,
what?
He's eating so much food on the track that it's dripping out of his cart?
Yes. That or his cart just like has a supply of ants, and he pushes a button and opens his mouth and shoots in, but some of them miss his mouth and, you know.
And get in other people's ears.
He has promised to stop snacking while he drives, and so far he has been true to his word.
Good thing he keeps texting. He won't drink and drive like some people.
He won't drug and drive right. Like Rocco. And then, Chloe is an aggressive lion cub. Her vehicle is a great mix of speed and agility. Yet she has better stats across the board than two of the other people. You can't have 4-3-3 and then have two people with 2-2-2 in your game.
Yeah. At the very least, their numbers should add up, even if you haven't balanced your game right.
Yeah. One of the best all-rounders.
True, I guess.
Yeah. Chloe has become quite arrogant due to her success as a racer. She is always teasing the other racers, especially Cadmus, who doesn't seem to mind much.
Okay.
Cadmus was that dragon dude, so I'm imagining like...
Yeah.
Like, Cadmus. Your ancestors killed all those people, Cadmus! No, I don't care.
No, I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a fuck.
And I'll kill you too if you talk like that again.
Yeah. He tells you that you're gonna die.
Give me one more game.
He tells you that you're gonna die, but in that nice, charming little smile. Wow. Dude.
Yeah.
You're still fighting for first place.
Is that the first place guy?
Yeah. You got
well,
behind
I mean,
him
I was
and you
trying
went,
to do a lap.
You
I
got behind trying... him and you went in second.
I was trying to do a lap backwards.
Anyways, then Picasso. Picasso is probably the greatest racer of all the characters. I mean, you read this to me, but... A quiet fellow, he drives the fastest vehicle, is heavy enough to barge most characters out of his path, and handles like a pro. He has to keep an eye on Ahab and Polly, but for the most part, Picasso is king of the track.
Is he racist? What's going on? He has to keep an eye on those two? Why those two?
Yeah. He has to make sure they don't get into any trouble.
Why isn't he keeping an eye on that one drug addict?
Ahab and Polly are the two people with full mass, so...
Wow, so he's just, like, a fatophobe?
Yeah, no fat dudes on the racetrack.
Come on. He's all about thinspiration.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Nearly hit that mine, which operates the same way as a grenade.
Yeah.
Why is there a grenade animal? Here, look in the thing for the weapons.
Right,
it's like the page right before the.
You never did get that. About the weapons.
Yeah.
Weapon pickup. Drive over this to pick up one of the following weapons. I'll just read them. Speed up. Drive over this to get a quick boost of speed. This is very useful after colliding with a wall. Because the game knows you'll collide with walls. Collide with all the walls.
Yeah.
Tomahawk missile. Launch this weapon and 3 unguided missiles launch ahead of your vehicle. Guided missile. This missile flies straight down the track when launched and will hit the plane in front of you automatically. Okay, mine. That. The mine deploys immediately behind you when launched. When a racer collides with it, they will come to a halt and spin.
Oh.
Grenade. The grenade is tossed out the back of the vehicle and is left in the middle of the track. When a racer collides with it, they will come to a halt and spin.
It's the same thing.
The only difference is, the mine's deployed immediately behind you, and the grenade is tossed out the back of the vehicle.
So maybe, like, next time I get a grenade, I'll look behind me and fire it.
Oh, there you
go. Okay, on a straightaway.
Are there any straightaways?
Yeah, like, right here. Trust me, I know this track. That looks
nope, it just drops right behind you.
That's the fucking mine.
That's the mine.
It's the mine with the different sprite.
So why is the grenade even in here?
Oh my god!
He really cut you off there.
I'm pretty sure I dropped those.
Oh, warning to owners of projection TVs. Do not connect your PlayStation game console to a projection TV without first consulting the user manual for your projection TV, unless it is of the LCD type. Otherwise,
it might turn the characters real.
Yeah.
They'll come out of your TV and turn you
off. And kill you.
And one of them will kill you for crack money.
Yeah. Rocco or whatever.
Yeah, Rocco.
And then shield. This forms a protective field around your racer, making you invulnerable to all other weapons. You could still collect weapons when the shield is on. This is very useful when you're in the lead. It doesn't say that if people run into your shield, they slow.
Get fucked up.
They come to a halt and spin.
Yeah. Is that it? That's all of them?
I mean, that's all of them. That's all we've seen. You know?
Yeah.
Got missile that shoots off into three, the homing missile, which you're not getting since you're in first, the shield, the mine, the grenade, the boost.
Ah!
It's okay, you're invulnerable.
The shield. Yeah. I'm about to lap these fuckers.
Not anymore.
Nope. I was just doing sick tricks.
A backflip to a 720.
Is that really a 720? I thought it was just a 360.
No, you do two rotations.
Just a two?
Yeah.
Paying attention. I don't need to pay attention to play this game.
Man.
Bet you I could do this blindfolded. I don't think I could. There's no sound cues. Okay, I don't remember the track.
I was closing his eyes then.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. He's still on you.
Yeah, he and I are both lapping everybody else.
Yeah.
There's six racers. I've lapped two of them.
I'm really...
Those are the other two.
I'm really interested to see, you know, what the time difference...
Labbed.
Will be. Oh, you tried to take a shortcut?
Yeah.
You tried to take a shortcut and the game said no. No, no.
They tried to take a shortcut, but I said no.
They tried to give me a good game. I said no. I said no, let me play ATV Racers in peace.
Yeah. Look at this. Fuck you.
Fuck
you in your mind.
You've got this down to a science.
Yeah, except that I still crash into shit.
Yeah.
Hey, do you see those, like, burns on the ground? By the way, I'm just holding X. I never use brake.
Wow. 5 in turning is so overpowered, then.
Uh-huh.
Because you get even, like, a 4 in turning, and you can't take any of these.
Yeah. I'm not letting up at all.
Okay.
I haven't let up since the race started. Oh, that one just disappeared.
Maybe we reached the memory limit.
Yeah.
Too many sprites.
What if it just started despawning racers?
Too many sprites on screen. What if it just started despawning, you know?
I really like the lack of anything outside the bubble. There was just like, what's the color of ocean? Blue-green? Yeah, let's just make it that.
Oh, there's some grass on the sides.
Yeah, and beyond the grass?
Nothing.
Nothing. There's like a rock.
Except for the things that pop in, you know, like when you're right next to them. Like, it blows my mind that they force you to stay in the track, but outside of the track, at least in here, they have these, like, bumps and stuff it looks like you could ride
There's
on.
Even, like, a path off to the left there that, like,
could be a
like
shortcut.
Something that could be a shortcut, or maybe, like, just, like, a bump. Like, an alternate path. Anything.
But no.
No. They don't let you. I'm gonna guess there's somebody, like, real close ahead of me that I could probably lap again. Because I saw, like, some sparkles.
You scroll for a little bit.
Oh, yeah, sure. I think there's probably somebody up ahead who I can... Well, I don't know. I have only 8 laps left.
Yeah.
Some poor schmuck.
You're in the home stretch of ATV Racers. What do you think?
I think this might be the first LP I've done for you.
Yeah.
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 I'm honored
to say. This isn't even a Let's Not Play, you know? I mean, the X-Blades, that game, we accidentally played the whole thing.
Well, I mean, we didn't look at all the tracks, did we?
Hey, we might as well have.
I guess that's true.
ATV Racers, we pretty much...
There's less variety in this game than there is in...
Yeah.
God, this track is so short. Oh, fuck you.
He sent that thing from, like, 5 minutes ago.
See, you see that up there? That looks like somebody getting hit by something. The sparkles.
Oh, I didn't see, nah.
Oh, here, let's see. You might see sparkles up ahead.
Of course.
And the sparkles up ahead, I think, are people running into traps.
Every time you go through this track, you're dropping more shit for you to run into. I think this is all your shit.
Pretty much, at this point. I'm the only one actually...
This is an allegory.
Asshole.
This is an allegory.
I'm just I'm running away from my own problems. And...
Yeah, no, you're leaving, you're dropping all the shit, and you're the one that's gonna have to deal with it.
But that's not necessarily true.
We're cluttering up space, we're cluttering up our oceans, we're cluttering up our world. You know?
And you know who's left in the dust?
Who?
The animals.
The animals, yeah.
Including the dinosaurs?
Yeah, yeah. The dinosaur isn't making it out.
Oh, that's just the stuff.
Thing despawning.
Despawning, never mind. I was really hoping that was somebody I could lap again.
It makes me so sad that after 45 laps, you've possibly, like, gone a lap and a half around someone, and that's it. Like, you're never gonna double lap anyone after 45 laps.
Yep. That's the difference between a 1 and a 5 in speed.
Yeah.
Because I've got a 1.
Yeah. But you're winning.
I'm still not... I refuse to let go of Accelerate, so... Even when I'm crashing into a wall, I refuse to let go of Accelerate.
You could have just taped X down a long time ago.
I could have. My thumb is starting to hurt. Actually, my thumb hurts a lot.
Tell me about it.
It hurts.
Yeah. Anything else? You're on 47, you know, so...
Yeah. This is the best lap.
This lap.
If I'm just gonna quit, this would be the one to do it.
No, this would be the one not to do it.
I don't know, it's 47.
Why does that make you want to quit?
It's 47.
Oh, and?
It's at 47.
Yeah. So what? Dude,
so
I'm
I can
awesome.
Finish on a high note.
I think you should finish the track. Like,
yeah,
you're so close to the end.
It's too late now.
Yeah, I mean...
Maybe I should just quit now.
No!
Quit 2 laps from the end.
Quit now. Damn, dude, is this what NASCAR drivers feel like?
No, NASCAR drivers don't have to turn right.
Is this what someone who... You know what I mean by that. They drive 2.5 hours straight, you know, with maybe taking a pit stop or two, but like, you know... Oh, shit,
there's someone up there. If I get to lap someone, oh my god.
If you get, like, one more boost...
Oh my god, I'm about to have such an erect penis.
You don't have an erect penis.
It's not erect yet, but it's about to be.
Oh.
That's the first guy. Oh my god, I relapped
him. You're double. You relapped him.
My next CD is going to be called Relap.
Relapped. Yeah. I'm not afraid to lap again.
Everybody's gonna...
Did you win?
No.
Oh, one more lap.
Oh my god.
Huh. They were out of your sight for so long, and then they finally, like, just appear in front of you, and you're already past them.
Yep. So, I've lapped those three...
Twice.
I haven't lapped the guy in second place. He's probably, like, still right on my tail.
No, there's six people, so you haven't lapped... the guy in third place again, but second place is probably right.
No, I'm pretty sure I lapped the third place guy as well.
No, I think you just lapped three people.
Just right now, I just re-lapped three people. But I
lapped... Oh, but third place would be lapped behind you.
Yeah,
yes.
Once.
Yes. Once. All right, you did it. You want to see your stats? Want their stats?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, see?
You know who... See? Picasso right behind me.
No, it goes 1, 2.
Oh, I see.
26-23, so the guy was like...
So that looks like the Lion Cub.
The guy was like 9 seconds behind you.
9 seconds?
Yeah. You could have...
Look at this sixth place time. That's a two full minutes behind me.
Yeah.
Christ. That was great.
ATV racers.
Would you mind if I did that again?
Oh, sure.
No, not right now.
Oh, later, then yeah.
Like... Oh, no, I guess maybe you should do it.
I don't want to do it.
No, I mean, you should do it so that I can be jacking off at the time.
Alright.
As soon as you pass the 50 lap.
That was ATV racers. We saw all there was to see after 30 seconds, and then we continued for like another, a half hour.
Yeah, another 45 minutes.
Alright.
That was wonderful. That's, the Anthro Block
that's
has
the
been
end
such
the,
an arousing
that's
experience
That's the end
for
of
me.
The Anthro Block.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But now, it's time to do another block. Hopefully as the games go uphill this time instead of downhill.
Instead of just leveling off like this one did?
It didn't even go downhill yet.
It didn't go up or down. It just stayed at the same elevation.
We're going to continue with racing some ATVs, and we're going to get a little off-road fury.
Oh, shit. I'm going to be so mad.
Yeah, I'm going to be so
and
pissed.
And off-road?
Every single time.
What's the full game name?
ATV Off-Road Fury 2.
Oh, shit.
We'll see you guys next time.